Hello everyone, continuing the series of videos guiding you on how to use the cTrader platform on ICMarkets. In this video, I will guide you on how to set up and manage indicators as well as trading robots on the cTrader platform. With this management method, you can quickly install indicators and trading robots on many different product tabs, which is convenient for you in determining market trends.
Welcome to the IB Support Channel. This information channel guides you about the ICMarkets platform. If you are new to ICMarkets, please subscribe to the channel to receive the most useful information.
With a blank product chart like this, it is quite difficult for us to determine the market trend. And usually, we will have the need to add more indicators here to support trend identification. The way we add indicators on the cTrader platform is a bit different from the MetaTrader 4 or MetaTrader 5 platforms, because its interface has many changes. And here, when you want to add an indicator, you will find the F-shaped tab at the top here. It's this tab. Pay attention to its icon. The next step, you choose the group of indicators that you want to put on the screen. For example, I'll go into the trend indicator group. Here I can install many different indicators. For example, I will choose the simple moving average indicator. So I will click on it. The next step, I will set the parameters for this simple moving average indicator. I will adjust its period. For example, I will adjust it to 50 here. Then I will adjust the color for the indicator. The line type of the indicator. I can choose one of these line types. And here I will choose the line weight. And after finishing editing the information of these indicators, we click OK, and then we will be able to put the indicator on the screen like this. Similarly, if you want to install other indicators, you just need to click on the F and find the indicator you want to use. During the process of installing indicators, there are also some additional notes. When you go to the F section and select any indicator, even though we have put it out like this, in this control panel, we can completely select many other indicators. Or in a trend indicator like this, we can select many different indicators in it. Here, it has a list of different indicators belonging to the trend indicator group that you can choose here. Instead of having to painstakingly search for those indicators in the control panel section like this, you can click on the indicator, and the selection will also be more convenient. For example, I will choose an indicator, which is the oscillators indicator. I will click on it to choose stochastic. Then, the next step, I will set the parameters of the stochastic. For example, I will set it to 10, 5, 5. Then, I will set the color for this indicator. I will make both of them red. After setting the information of the indicator, I will click OK, and I have also put the indicator on the screen like this. You see that the window of this indicator is quite large. It will take up the space of the product chart. I will make this chart smaller by moving the mouse cursor to the middle area here. And you will see that it will change from a mouse cursor to a two-way arrow. At that time, I will click the left mouse button and drag this screen down. So I have neatly dragged this indicator section and expanded the product chart section. For indicators that create a new window like this, when you no longer want to use them, you just need to click on the X icon. I have removed that indicator. And for indicators that follow the price line like this, when you want to edit them, you move the mouse cursor to the indicator, and it will light up like this. You right-click on it, and it will display the information of the indicator. If you want to delete this indicator, when it displays like this, you can click on the trash can icon. And so, if I want to add any other indicators, I will click on the F again and find the desired indicator. Now I will install Bollinger bands. These are the default parameters of Bollinger bands. The indicator installation in cTrader is more convenient than on the MetaTrader 4 or MetaTrader 5 platforms. For example, with Bollinger bands, here you can completely set the display for each line. For example, you can display the main line, or the upper Bollinger bands, or the lower Bollinger bands. You can edit the color for each line, or the line type for each line. For example, here I will remove the main part. I will only display the upper and lower lines. Then I click OK. So you see that Bollinger Bands normally has 3 lines displayed. Now it only has 2 lines, which are the upper and lower lines. I have removed the middle line. If I want the middle line to be displayed again, I will right click on it. I will click on here and now I will change the color of the middle line. I will change it to yellow. Then I click OK. So you see that it is quite flexible compared to other trading platforms. In case you want to use trading robots, you will find the tab next to the tab with an icon like a robot's head. This is the list of available robots on the cTrader platform of the ICMarkets broker that the broker provides to us. If you understand the specific functions of each of these robots, you can put them on the screen to use them by clicking on the corresponding robot, and then you perform the settings here. Here I don't really understand this robot, so I'm just giving you an example of the editing operation. After editing the information of this robot, we will click on Apply here, and you see that the robot has been displayed in the section below here. It is displaying a button like this, which means this robot is not active yet. If you want this robot to be active, you click on this button. When you click on it, the robot will officially start working, and when you click on it, you will also see the robot icon in the section above here. This means there is a robot active. If you want to stop the activity of this robot, you will need to turn it off here. When you click here, there is also a change. This product tab is now back to being the same as the previous product tab. It no longer has a robot icon there. If you no longer want to use this robot, you will click on the X icon. Regarding the settings related to that robot, you can go to the left column here. You click on the 3 horizontal lines. You select the Automate section. Here you will also see information about the trading robots that we encountered in the robot head icon section that we clicked on the button at the top earlier. Right, and when you go to this section, if you want to learn more about a specific robot, you will click on it. Then you will get information about the robot as well as its programming language here. Through this, you can learn about the specific algorithm in that robot. You can completely refer to and edit the information from that robot. If you want to add trading robots from outside into the cTrader platform, you can select any cBot. You click on the 3 dots icon on the right side here. You select Show in Folder. This is the section containing the information of the trading robots. If you have trading robots on this cTrader platform and you want to add them to use, you will paste that indicator into this section. And after pasting the indicator into this section, we will restart the cTrader platform. And then that trading robot will appear in the cTrader installation so we can use it. From this section, if you want to go back to the trading chart section, you will click on the charts section. And then you will turn off this column on the side. We have returned to the main screen of the product chart like this. And when you have added the trading robots, you can go here to use them. The indicators I just installed are only applied to this product tab. The other product tabs do not have any indicators yet. If I want to transfer the indicator settings from this tab to the next product tabs, I will use a feature called template. You can right-click on the screen. You select the template section. Then you select Save Template. Next, you name this template. Here I will name the template IC Trading 2. For example, I had already named IC Trading 1 before. After naming the template, I will click Save. Next, I will go to other product tabs. I will right-click on the screen. I will select the template section and I will find IC Trading 2. This way, very quickly, I have transferred the indicator settings from this tab to the next tab. And so, I can install indicators for other product tabs like this. I will also right-click. I select Template and IC Trading 2. And so, here I have finished introducing to you the method of using indicators, trading robots, as well as some tricks for setting up these indicators and trading robots. I hope the information I have provided is useful to you. Thank you for watching the video.